Good morning students. Today we are going to see exercise 5.2 from data handling. Okay, this exercise on pie chart. We have yesterday learned about the pie chart. Okay, so first example, a survey was made to find the type of music that a certain group of young people like in a activity. Here one group of the young people is there, and here we have done is here survey was made to find the type of music that a certain group of young people like. Okay, so this adjoining pie chart, this pie chart shows the findings of this survey, means what they find from this survey, how many people, how many young people like each type of activity. Okay, so from the chart we have to answer the following. Here these people are divided, young people are divided into in these activities. 40% young people like light activities, like then semi-classical, 20% classical, 10% and for 30%. These are the activities, and it is divided into this what by 40% is where they have divided, right? So actually we don't know how many 30%, 10%, 20% means how many young people are there. Okay, so here the first question is, if 20 people like classical music, where is the classical music? This, right? 20 people like a classical music, how many young people were surveyed? We have to find how many total number of people that survey and when. So we have to find out how many young people were surveyed. Okay, so here there we don't know how many total people are there. So we will take let young people be x divided. Okay, means total number of people are, young people are x. So this in x includes all classical, semi-classical, light and folk. Okay, so from these x and people, there are the 20, how many are there? There are 20 people like the classical music, right? So 10 percentage of x, that is your 20. Okay, here percentage of the young people, those who like the classical, it is given 10%, right? So 10% it is given of how many total young people are there. We have taken, we don't know, so we have taken here x. So 10% of x equals to, actually 10% is how many people are there who like the classical music? 20. So 10% of x equals to 20, that we will find out. So 10, how we will write 10%? 10 by 100, correct? 10 by 100 into this x equals to 20. Okay, this get cancel, 0, 0. Now 1 by 10, here what is remaining? 1 by 10 is multiple to x, and we have to find out x. Okay, so x equals to this 20 as it is, and this 1 by 10 is multiplied here, there you go divide, means indirectly the in the division their reciprocal will be there. So here will be the 10 divided by 1, so it means that 10. So 20 into 10 is 200 young people are there. Okay, so x equals to young people. Understood? Here what we have done, 10% of, let me have taken the young people's be x, so 10% of x from that 20 persons are, they like the classical music. Okay, so 10% of x is equals to 20. So how you write 10 by 100 into x equals to 20, so this 0 get cancelled, so remaining 1 by 10. After transferring this side, we have to find the x. So 20 as it is, this 1 by 10 reciprocal will be there 10/1. Okay, so you will get x equals to 200 young people. And see what has, what they ask, how many young people we are serving. Okay, so here how many? 200 people. Okay, now next is what? Which type of music is liked by the maximum number of people? So from here, from the percentage only we can, means we can give the answer of this question. Which type of music is liked by the maximum number of people? Maximum number of people means more people. So which type has given the maximum percentage? Of course, this is light, okay? 40%, okay? So here what is the answer? Yeah, light. Understood? Okay, next question. If a cassette company were to make thousands of CDs, how many each type of they make, right? So how much percentage of the young people like particular activity, that much CDs will be there, correct? Na? So if 40% young people like 20% is like semi-classical, 10% is like classical and folk like 30%, 30% like folk, then that much cassettes will be there for sale, right? So we will find out. So here, how many total CDs are there? 1000. Okay, total CDs are 1000. Now actually 10% young people like classical. So from this 10% of these are the CDs for the classical. 20% young people like semi-classical. So from this total number of the CDs, 20% CDs for this. Here 40% CDs for this and here 30%. So actually what are the numbers that we will find out? Okay. So total number of CDs are 1000. So for classical we will find first. For classical, what is 10%? So we will find for the classical half, 10/100, 10% of 1000. Okay, 10% of 1000. So this 00 get cancelled and this 0 get cancelled. So how many are there? 100. Okay, so how many cassettes of this classical? 100 cassettes. Okay, here 100 cassettes. Okay, then afterwards 20% semi classical. So for semi classical we will find semi classical how many semi classical? 20%. So we have to find out 20% of 1000. Okay, this 00 get cancelled and this 00 get cancelled. So 100 into 2, how many? 200 CDs will be there. So here how many CDs? 200 CDs. Okay, here CDs, right? Then 40% for light. Next, 40% for light. So we will find out how many actual CDs, right? So 40 upon 100 into how many? 1000. Okay, this 120 get cancelled. So you will get 40 into 10. So 400. So how many cassettes and CDs are there? 400 CDs. Okay, and last one is for 30%. So here 30 upon 100 into 1000. 1, 2, this get cancelled. So here you will get 300. Okay, so how many series are there for the 4? 300 series. Understood everyone? Now we will see next question. Now next question. A group of 360 people were asked vote for their favorite season from the three seasons: rainy, winter and summer. Okay, so here three seasons are there: summer, rainy and winter. And number of votes means here how many numbers like summer season, how many numbers of people like rainy season, and how many numbers of people like winter season. Okay, so here we have to find which season got most vote. So which season got most vote? From here only we can understand how which season: winter season. Okay, so we write here answer: winter season. Okay, then next question: find central angle of each sector. So we have to find out what is the central angle for each sector. If you want to present this information in pie chart, so there must be the requirement of central angle. Okay, so here we have to find out what is the central angle for each sector, and finally we have to find out, draw a pie chart to show this information. So we have to draw pie charts also. Okay, so to draw pie chart we need central angle, and that is into the second question. Okay, so now here first we will find out what is the total number, how many total numbers of voters here. Okay, so total we will find out here: 0, 9 plus 2, 11, 11 plus 5, 16, and here 1 is 3. Okay, so total number of voters are how many? 360. Okay, now we will find the central angle of each sector. So first we will take here, first answer, so answer for, okay, solutions for okay. So find the central angle for each sector. So first we will find summer. How to find summer? Okay, so if you have to find the central angle, so it is related to the angle. Okay, so how many voters are there? They like summer. How many? 90, right? So 90 out of how many total numbers of voters are? 360. Okay, so by 360 into, we have to find the central angle, right? Then how many total angles here? Measurement of total angle of the circle is of course 360. Here we are making the central angle, so 360. Okay, so into 360. So if we have to find the central angle, we have to multiply with the 360 degree. Okay, so this 360 and this 360 will get cancelled. So how many you got the central angle? 90 degree. Okay, so this is very important when you are finding the central angle for a particular sector or for the particular atom. So it is shown in the degree. Okay, next is what? Rainy. Second is rainy. Okay, so rainy, how many people are there? 120. Out of 360 multiplied by what is the angle? 360 degree. Again this 360 get cancelled. So you got here 120 degree. That is the central angle for rainy season. Okay. So then next, third is what? Winter. Okay. So how many winter for? 150. Now you got here idea of this 360. Here total number of people or total number of voters and this central angle, it is total central angle is 360 degree. So here you will get 150 degree angle. Okay, for this is the winter. Now next question: draw a pie chart to show this information. Now for the pie chart requirement, there is a requirement of central angle, that is ready with us. Now we will draw a pie chart. Okay, so here we have to draw a circle with any convenient radius, any measurement we can take, right? And this is your center. Afterwards we have to join this center to the any point on the circle. Okay, now first I want to draw a 90 degree angle for the summers. Okay, so we have to find out, or we have to draw a sector for this 90 degree. So what we will do, we will take the protractor, we will keep on this side and we will start from 0, 10, 20, 0, 10, 20, 30, like this up till 90 degree. So here 90 degree angle will come. So we will draw this line. So this is the sector we have selected for 90 degree angle, means what, for summer. Okay, next is for any, how many quarters are there? 120. So how many degree angle we got sector angle? 120 degree, right? So this 120 degree means from here to here remaining 90 degree, right? So 120 degree will be outside. So 90 means we will, again what we will do, we will keep the protractor on this side and we will start from this 0, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, then 100, 110 and 120. Suppose 120 we got here, so this we will join, right? Now this is the central angle, 120 degree for which season? Rainy season. Okay, and what is the remaining? 150 degree. So there is only one remaining, so automatically this will come 150 degree for which season? Winter season. Okay, understood everyone?